Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll see how to use existing templates available in Microsoft Power Automate RPA tool. So here, if we can see, there is already existing created templates by Microsoft team where we can use the templates for building or end-to-end RPA flow. So when we'll click on these type of templates, it will navigate us to the flow. And here we can see either we can create it from scratch, otherwise. I've already used one of the templates here. So if you can see, just click on this. And if you want to edit this options, click on this edit icon. And this will navigate us to the flow where we can specify or edit this flow. Now, this flow is generally built for triggering an automated email. So if you can see here, this is my email box. So this will trigger an email to the configured email ID. So if you can see here, this is my email box. I have already sent an email for this flow, and this email will looks like this. Now, if I want to trigger this email again, simply I have to run the flow or just test the flow. Here, once we'll click on test flow, it will ask the options to test the flow manually or automatically. This time I am trying with the manual flow. Click on test and this will start executing the process. Here we have to specify the email subject. So I'm just writing executing existing templates and email body. I'm just writing test here. Click on run flow. And once the flow will be completed in my inbox, I will get another email from this. And you can see this is the subject name which I specified and the body is written here. So this is how we can use existing flow. If you want to modify this flow, we can also modify by selecting or adding some nodes or changing the settings, or we can also add other flow or in between steps. So these are the flow which is triggered automatically and post updating this flow. Once we'll click on save, this process will be saved successfully. If we want to check this complete flow, here we don't have any error message and again we don't have any warning. So this is how the flow checker is working. Now, if you want to specify or use any other flow, we can also use it. But if you can see here, the complete execution flow from last 28 days, I processed or executed this flow twice. And I can see this detail is available at what time I've executed it. If I want to delete this flow from my repository, simply I will click and delete it from here. Again, if I want to make a copy of this, so I will create a copy. Submit as a template. If we have built this flow from our side, we can also submit this as a template to Microsoft Power Automate team. We can also extract this flow for our external users, so those who don't have their account and they want to integrate it to their platform. We can also export it. In analytics systems, we can see the complete analytics about this flow. So how many times we have executed, what is the usage of this flow, and how many times we have received an error. So from last 30 days, it will generate a very interactive execution report where we can see this process has been executed successfully. In the user's point of view, we can also see the complete usage about this flow. So if we have any uses repository where we have deployed, we can also see it. Now you can see here, these are the uses. In error sections, we don't have any error sections, so definitely we will not get any errors. But whenever we will have this error sections, we will be able to see in this analytics report. Now, For generating this type of or creating this type of flow, we can submit this as a template to Microsoft Power Automate team. So that's all from this video. Hope you like the content. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.